go. Ooh, today I am having Jollibee. I love Jollibee. The last time I had it, I was not happy. It wasn't the best. So I'm hoping today they redeem themselves. I want some good Jollibee today. I got spicy, all spicy. Let's see. And a little bumblebee. Ooh, it looks good. It looks good. Let's see if y'all get a good close-up look at that chicken. Okay. Ooh, yes. I got mashed potatoes and gravy. And more gravy. Because Jollibee likes you to have the gravy. Let's see, I'm just going to open those. I actually got two mashed potatoes and two gravies. I only ordered one of each. But I think one gravy came with the chicken. But I think I got a free mashed potatoes and gravy. And I'm okay with free. I like free. Free is good. And I got a Palabok or Palabok Fiesta. I got that. I did not get the family size. That's okay. Ooh, smells shrimpy. Smells rather shrimpy today. And I got the Jolly Spaghetti. I'm going to keep this lid for my chicken. Let's see, we try to move stuff around just a little. And I got salt and pepper. I got the salt and pepper I was going to put on my mashed potatoes. I don't know what that sound is. Okay. Alrighty. Let me get the chicken first. Let's see. I got a thigh. Spicy. See. Now ready. Looks really crispy today. Okay. Palabok needs to move. Palabok, how do you pronounce that? Oh, big hunk of skin. Oh my gosh. Oh my goodness. Mm. I got a 6-piece bucket. That looks like a lot of chicken. Chicken. That is good chicken. Oh, and it's plenty spicy today. I think that's spicier than Popeye's. Fiesta. I did not order extra sauce, but dang. That looks pretty amazing. Oh, a little crispy chicharrones. Wow, they went light on the noodles though, didn't they? Compared to the toppings and the sauce. Wow, they really, really packed on the sauce today. Got the little baby shrimp. Wow. It's juicy. And hot. Super hot. Wow. That bite was very porky. Piece of egg. Wow. Spicy. Oh. Oh yes. Crunch is nice. I want that gravy. Okay. Chicken's good. All right, mashed potatoes and gravy. Extra gravy if I need it, obviously. They did not have the adobo rice, or I would have definitely gotten some of that. It may have been just fine with no salt and pepper, but the little salt and pepper packet I had from my utensil set that actually like pumped it up a little bit. Yep. Oh, good. Wow. Ooh. Another chicken dip. Oh man. A&W root beer. Zero sugar, because, you know, why not? Oh, I wanted some bubbles. That's exactly why. Whew. Oh yeah, that was spicy. That was a spicy bite. Oh. Dropping potatoes. Oh man, that spice has me snorting. Ooh. All right, well, before I get to digging it up too much. Skitties. It's got the hot dogs in it chopped up and the cheese on top. Ooh, yeah. Ooh. Oh. Now, after you've had this type of spaghetti, you kind of crave it. You know what I can't find anywhere? Like a Cincinnati style. It's kind of a chili spaghetti. I know, I'm gonna have to look at a recipe and make that for myself, I guess. I'm gonna have to pause in a minute and blow my nose. This is getting serious. You guys, I am very satisfied with my food today. A plus. All right, pause. Okay. Oh, goodness. More chicken. And another, another thigh. Okay. All right, it was only 6 pieces. Just look like a very full bucket. Look at that chicken. Look at it, y'all. Oh my God. Wow. Jeez. Oh. Okay. So I finished one of the books I was working on recently. Anne Rice's The Wolf Gift. It's the first book in her like werewolf series. It's pretty good. I'm very interested to see how the story continues. It's basically like the origin of the whole whatever is what's going on in the first book. Explanations and all that stuff. This doesn't have a bone in it. Mm-mm. And I was glad I finally got to read that book. And Rice is no longer with us, so. I want to be able to, like, complete all of the book series that I started. I think I read all of the Mayfair Witch Chronicles, and I have one more book in the Vampire Chronicles. I have two books in the Mummy series. Then she's got a book about angels, I think. And then another couple of books about Jesus Christ. Which, you know, I'll read them. I'll read them. I ain't got no problems with Jesus. You know that song, Jesus is just all right with me. Don't copyright me, y'all. But, I just love her writing style. It's very eloquent, very romantic. I love the romanticism. My hips hurting today. Damn. Ugh. When it's like that, I say it's being grumpy. My hips being grumpy today. It's like throbbing. One hip. Oh, okay. Anyway, too much fat on this piece. Some of that off. Ugh. Okay. Well, I have a couple of other books that I'm working on. J.R.R. Tolkien's The Silmarillion. Slow going. I've got 9 hours left. And I just bought, with a credit on Audible, an H.P. Lovecraft anthology, basically. His complete weird fiction works. And that is 83 hours worth of books. But it's basically like his entire body of work. The introduction, each either poem, short story, or whatever, has like an introduction. And then they also make sure to like touch on some of the more controversial aspects of Lovecraft. Which, you know, it's problematic, but in that time, in like the 1920s, just about every Caucasian person was problematic. It was pretty close. It was like across the board, you know. So, it was just a product of the time, and there's no excuse, but still, you know, the work kind of stands on its own, and while some of the writings may have something that'll kind of make you cringe a little bit, overall, the body of work is lovely. Anyway, so I'm enjoying some creepy stories. Right now, he's working on a poem. Oh gosh, I forgot the name of it. And it just started, so I haven't like heard the name but once. Oh my goodness. But basically this one poem is longer than most of his short stories, so I'm like, okay. He's very, very wordy. Very wordy, but his descriptive words, like cyclopean and, well, that's like one of the main words. It's like, what even is that? There's something in my teeth. And it's like stuck. Weird. Feels weird. And I'm also working on George R.R. Martin's A Game of Thrones, like book one in the series. And I can already tell, it's like, oh my God, I've watched Game of Thrones so many times. It's like the book is ruined for me. But still, I'm excited to see where all it differs. The book differs from the show. And slowly, I'm plugging away at Milton's Paradise Lost. It's pretty good so far. I mean, again, very wordy, old style. But I like it. Oh, okay, I'm covered in crumbs. Ooh. All right, I have to stop for a minute. Pause. Okay. Ooh. Yeah, I had to take a quick break. My hip is not being nice today. Not being nice at all. Oh, man. Ooh. You know, if you guys are adventurous at all and you like the taste of shrimp and pork, this halibut fiesta. It's definitely worth giving a try. Oh. In fact, Jollibee is just, it's worth a try anyway. Just because it's like the chicken and the spaghetti. It's like, it's the same, but different. But this is a very Filipino dish. All right, that's it for me. Three pieces of chicken. And about half of all the sides. There's three pieces left in there. Two legs and a thigh. All right. Mm. I have my famous Jollibee peach mango pie. Woo! I'm excited about this. Oh, crispy. Mmm. My gosh. Come on. No. See the peach mango innards? Oh. It's so warm and delicious. Oh. Wow. I'm gonna save a little bite for later. Oh my God. Well, you guys, that was an incredibly satisfying meal today. I'm happy I have a few leftovers for dinner. It's lunch. Well, it's lunch for me. It's like after 5 o'clock. And I have to edit this tonight, so it's Tuesday. Oh, and again, something exciting is coming. It's coming. Let's do a little vague posting. Oh gosh, I'll be so excited to share this with you guys. Fun. Anyway, vague. I just had to. Y'all either love it or hate it. Like, just be excited for me that something good is coming. Anyway. Oh, I thank you guys for spending time with me today. I love you very much, and I will see you next time. Bye now.